And now I really enjoy it and I'm grateful for everything they've done for me. What about you? So you say you've just moved into your host family. What's it like?
I'm on my own. It was like better than I expected it was going to be. It was interesting to hear about him also doing the host family. It's good to know that someone like him, of what he's done, has been in the same position as me. When you were around my age, you were quite small for your age, like me. How did you deal with it?
I found it really hard, to be honest. When I was probably even younger than you, I was like probably the smallest in the team, playing against players that are double my size. I really struggled to deal with it and cope with it. But over time, you grow and you gain confidence, and then things just start happening for you. And then that's when you can just take it within your stride and you start excelling above the big players. So I think maybe it might be tough now, but over time it'll definitely pay off.
It was really like inspiring for me to see someone like him. He had some struggles along the way. But if you look where he is now, hopefully as I get older, I end up playing with you one day.
Hopefully. Pass the ball through for me to score, hopefully.
Yeah, hopefully.
Gathers through to Ballard. It's got a nice ring to it.
Thank you, Dom. It's been like a great experience for me to talk to you. It was great to get like an insight from how he's achieved what he's done and the route he took. And I just picked up loads of things from him.
Gathers' attitude, work rate and talent are already being recognised. He was then called up to the under-18s for three matches, including helping them beat West Brom in this game. Yeah, that's a 15-year-old playing for the under-18s.
Next season, my main goals are more minutes with the 18s and hopefully 23s, and the big goal for me is training with the first team.
Way to go, Gathers! I'll be cheering you on from the sidelines. Well, from my voiceover booth.
Hello?
Yes, can I have a cup of tea, please? Welcome to Leeds, 235 miles from Southampton. It's home to hit CBBC show Jamie Johnson and new series Jamie Johnson FC. The twins, Gathers and other academy stars have travelled 6 hours on a coach with their coach, Alice. They're here to take on the cast of the new JJFC show.
When we got called to play against Jamie Johnson's cast, it was really exciting. But also at the same time, I was nervous.
This game is meant to be a friendly, but one thing I've learned about footballers, there's no such thing as a friendly.
Well, I've spoken to the Jamie Johnson cast. We've told them, take it easy, but no, they're having none of it.
I want to win this more than anything, not gonna lie.
We thought this was a friendly at first, but no, it's not a friendly, we want to win.
As we have travelled such a long way to get here, we are not losing this, right, Kiki?
Right.
The twins are the youngest players here. So, if the team are going to win, they're going to have to be at their very best.
One, two, three, six!
We've not come all this way just to lose to a bunch of actors. We're going to smash them.
A bunch of talented footballing actors? Don't be so sure. Exactly. Who will be crowned CBBC champions and win bragging rights forevermore? And it is full of high drama. Goals, skills, Jamie Johnson, and even more on CBBC and BBC iPlayer. Next time on the Football Academy, can Venezuelan super striker Ali save the day and secure his spot in a once-in-a-lifetime tournament in Dubai?
Dubai is one of the best places in the world, hoping to get there.
Ava Rose meets the best keeper in the world.
Hey, Ava, how are you? Good, thanks.
Lioness Mary Earps. And there's an absolute nail-biter in the Under-12s Cup semi-final.
Can't watch.
Don't miss the Saturday Mashup live today at 9 a.m. only on CBBC.
Dodger and the gang are back.
Dodger,
to pull off the heist of the century.
We're going to nick the crown jewels.
I'm serious. If we can get our hands on that crown, we'll never go hungry again.
But it's not as simple as it sounds.
This is high treason, punishable by death.
Can Dodger pull off his riskiest scheme yet?
What are you waiting for?
Go and get it!
It's much harder being queen than people think.
Find out in brand new Dodger Coronation. Watch now on BBC iPlayer.
Getting creative now on BBC Two with Blue Peter.
I'm Abby.
I'm Joel.
And this is Henry. Join in and earn your Blue Peter badges.
Today is a Doctor Who takeover. Competition winner Verity visits the TARDIS and meets the stars of the show.
We show you how to make your very own meep.
And to kick things off, we have a truly out-of-this-world performance. Take it away, the Phoenix Boys!
Welcome to Blue Peter. And guess what, everyone? We are
live!
Yes, we are. And what an absolutely amazing performance. Shout out to the Phoenix guys here for an incredible performance to kick off our Doctor Who special. It was fantastic.
Absolutely. Now, if you're a hardcore Whovian or a brand Newvian, we've got something in store for everybody today.
That's absolutely. We have so much going on here. And let me tell you, I'm super excited to be here in studio. And Abby, we have so much stuff coming in for the competition because we teamed up with Doctor Who to celebrate 60 years of the show, asking you to send in your very own fan art. And we have some here, don't we, Abby?
We definitely do. But this competition was extra special as the top 500 entries earned themselves one of these. It's a limited edition Blue Peter Doctor Who badge. And I will say that the entries were out of this world. Let's take a look at some of them.
Yes, I can't wait.
Whoa, that's amazing. We've got some Daleks, we've got some TARDISes, we've got some images of the Doctor throughout the 60 years.
Monsters too, which I'm a big fan of.
Amazing.
Absolutely, Steph. And you know what? There were so many amazing entries that it was very difficult to actually choose a winner, but we had to. And this is the moment when we revealed Verity's winning design. Have a look.
The winner of our Doctor Who competition is...
one of the competition badges, but she also got to go behind the scenes at Doctor Who and meet the brand new Doctor.
I know, what's not to love about that? This is the very special moment where we joined her on a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, and honestly, you guys are going to absolutely love this. Check it out.
Verity has been watching Doctor Who since she was born. Both Mum and Verity are super fans of the show.
Here they come.
Hey!
Verity, what are you most excited about today?
To see what new monsters they have.
We've got a lot to see. Should we get to it?
Let's rock and roll.
Lead the way, Abby.
First up, I take Verity to meet costume designer Pam Down, who created the Doctor and Companion Donna's new look.
We start off by finding the shapes, and then we try stuff on them, and then we do the first fitting, and this is where David got into his character. As soon as we put the costume on, he was the Doctor.
I think that one's fun.
Yeah, it is. This is the actual costume. Verity, do you want to come have a feel of this? Mm. See what it's quite, it's a bit rough.
How many of these are there?
I think we made about 5 because we have to make some for the stuntman. The stuntman is usually bigger than David. Do you want to try something on?
Yeah. It's,
which one?
That one.
Donna's actual outfit. Wow, look at you.
You'll grow into it. It's fine.
And of course, Verity has to try on the doctor's coat.
Look at that.
And you're the only one apart from David Tennant that's worn it. Hey.
Whoa.
Next up on our adventure in the Hooniverse, we meet one of the executive producers and a judge for the Blue Peter fan art competition.
Now, Verity, this is Joel Collins.
Lovely to meet you. I loved what you did so much that I wanted to... have a proper look.
Wow.
I wanted to have a proper look. What's your favourite bit of it?
The Dalek. So, with the Gallifreyan writing, that one says, I want to win, and that one says, Verity. This one or this one says, Blue Peter.
That is amazing.
That's awesome.
Could I ask you to sign it?
Wow.
Verity is famous in the Doctor Who offices.
Woo! That looks amazing. Great.
What's your favourite monster?
Well, I love all the monsters, but I'm also excited to show you some of the monsters we've been putting together for the new season. Would you like me to show you how some of them come together?
Yes, please.
Well, let's go.
We've arranged special BP access to some of the brand new monsters. This is the Meep, not as cute as you might think. And this is a Roth puppet head. In Doctor Who, the Roth Warriors act as a police force to protect people from the Meep.
What we can see here, if you turn around, is a few of the creatures from the new series. We make real puppets and real suits with people.
Before being transformed into the computer graphic you see on screen. And the creator behind these monsters is award-winning film and TV art director Phil Sims.
Hello.
He is responsible for creating the new TARDIS and designing the monsters in the new series.
Wow, look at the size of your arm.
From sketches to 3D printing.
What do you think this is?
Is it the TARDIS?
It is the TARDIS, yeah. What gave it away?
All these are... paths, where do they actually lead to?
Should we go and have a look?
Yeah.
Let's go!
The TARDIS is a police box-shaped spaceship that allows the Doctor to travel through time and space. But before we head there, we've got one stop along the way.
Doctor Who are filming the new series, and we have special BP access to their actual filming set, where Verity gets to meet the stars of the show. Head of unit...
Kate Lethbridge-Stewart!
Returning companion after over 30 years, Melanie Bush.
I'll send you a postcard.
But I don't have an address.
Melanie, hello!
And the 15th Doctor with companion Ruby. Hey.
Melanie!
Congratulations!
I love your dungas. Look at them.
I know, they're well cool.
Look at me.
Have a look at this here, guys. This is the competition
winner. Oh, my God!
Oh,
no.
Isn't that great?
I know. Oh, we've got an artist on our hands.
How long did it take you to do that?
All weekend,
did it? Well, you absolutely have done an amazing job.
That is incredible.
And look at the Daleks at the top.
I was going to say, yeah.
Oh, Verity, come and design the actual
TARDIS. I know,
TARDIS.
Yeah.
What's it like being the Doctor?
It's a lot of responsibility. Mm. We've got a whole universe to save. But it's fun. It's a lot of fun, and you get cool gadgets, and you get to see all these cool monsters. We've got a whole host of new monsters coming up, Verity, that are very scary. Wow. So look forward to that.
Which Doctor were they filming when you started watching?
Ooh, when I, the first one, yeah. David's...
I'm not that old, really, thank you very much.
My first Doctor was David Tennant. Another fellow Scott.
Who's your favourite companion?
Very, very difficult. You're like, it's gotta be Ruby Sun. It's gotta be Ruby Sun.
That's good stuff. I got one last thing. You can't come on Blue Peter without getting one of these.
Oh.
So I'm gonna give this to you.
and have a look.
Oh, thank you, Verity. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Oh, come on, look at that. And it is actually law that you have to wear them in every Doctor Who episode from now on. That's how it works. That is the law.
It actually goes with the outfit.
Guys, thank you so much. Oh, we've enjoyed it.
Thank you so much.
Such a pleasure meeting you, Verity.
What an absolutely amazing prize to win. Absolutely extraordinary. And part two of that will be here on the show later on. You don't want to miss that. But for now, I am joined by Whovian, an official Doctor Who podcaster. It's Terrell Charles, everyone! Yeah. Good to see you, my friend.
Good to see you.
How are we doing?
I'm doing good. How are you?
Great to have you on the show. I'm good, thank you. Let me tell you, it's very exciting to have you here because you're the world's biggest Doctor Who fan. I want to know, when did you start watching the show?
Oh man, I started watching the show back in 2007, so I would have been about 10 or 11 at the time.
So which Doctor would that have been? Let me work it out.
That would have been David Tennant.
David Tennant? Yeah. Is he your favourite?
He is easily my favourite, yeah.
He is awesome, right? And Matt so Smith, cool. You know, David Tennant's incredible as well, of course. So you're a massive fan of the show and you've got the online podcast, the video. I mean, listen, that's got to be amazing. What's that like?
Oh, it's so good. Yeah, so the official Doctor Who podcast. Yeah. I get to me and some co-hosts talk about the newest episodes right after they air. Yeah. I've got the Doctor Who New to Who show, basically teaching fans about Doctor Who that might not know too much about it.
Yeah, you're literally educating the world Doctor Who. That's so cool. Do you have any, because you're in a cool position with Doctor Who, any like claim to fame with Doctor Who?
I mean, I've met a bunch of the cast, Matt Smith, Karen Gillan, Jodie Whittaker, here and there. I also got to speak to the production designer of the newest TARDIS, Phil Sims. So cool.
Proper behind the scenes stuff.
Oh yeah.
That is absolutely incredible. We have to dig deeper into the Whoniverse. So follow me, Terrell, because I thought since you're such a big fan of the show and since Abby here is also a massive fan of Doctor Who, that we would put your knowledge to the test in the ultimate who's who of who. That's very hard to say five times. In a quiz, are you guys up for playing a little quiz with me?
Oh yeah, I'm ready.
You're up for it?
Well, I'm going to ask you guys some questions. We're going to see who gets them right. And we have until we hear this sound to get them. Are you guys ready?
Oh yeah.
All right, we're going to take it away with you, Abby. Okay, your first question is, here we have a wonderful accessory, but which Doctor is famous for wearing it? And this is the accessory right here.
Oh, the bow tie.
The bow tie. Who do you think it belongs to?
I mean, that's Matt Smith's Doctor. That's my era.
You're saying Matt Smith?
Yes.
You're absolutely right. And here is Matt Smith, my favorite Doctor.
And clothes.
Including the bow tie.
Yeah, it's cool. Bow ties are cool.
Are you from another planet?
Yeah.
Okay.
Bow ties are cool.
Very, very cool. I'm going to start wearing one on the show. Right, Terrell, you're up next. We have another accessory for you. I would like you to tell me which Doctor do you think would have sported this particular accessory?
Oh, the celery stick. Oh, what do you guys think?
Ooh. What do you think, guys? Any ideas?
All right, I'm going to take
you're on your own, Terrell.
I'm going to take a guess. This was like classic Who. Mm-hmm. I'm going to say the fifth Doctor.
Which would be?
Peter Davidson.
He's absolutely right. We're going to take a blast from the past. It was the fifth Doctor, Steve Davidson. There he is. Very nicely done. Ooh, that's making me hungry. Next question for you, Abby. You will be served a delicious dinner, and I want you to tell me which Doctor you think ordered it for you. Here is your meal, Abby. It is jelly babies.
Nice. Okay, that must be. You actually have multiple choice
to make it easier for you. Look at this. Could be Peter Capaldi, David Tennant, or Tom Baker. We'll make this nice and easy for you.
Yeah, the scarf one. So we've got Tom Baker, fourth Doctor.
Is that Tom Baker?
Yes, I'm going to lock in my
answer. Absolutely right. And here is Tom Baker, classic Doctor Who. Loving that.
Shut up!
Isn't that so great? Right, next question for you, Terrell. Again, we have a meal for you. You don't have to eat it if you don't want to. And you're going to tell me which Doctor ordered. Let's see it, guys. Fingers and custard. Does that belong to Matt Smith, Jodie Whittaker, or Chris Eccleston?
That will be the delicious cuisine of Matt Smith, 11th
Doctor. Matt Smith, you guys agree?
Yeah, fish fingers and custard.
You're absolutely right. It is Matt Smith. Have a look. Here he is, eating his fish fingers and custard. Now that is the ultimate snack. Right, Abby, next question for you. I'm going to play you some music. Your job is to tell me which villain of the Doctor this song is associated with, and it is multiple choice. All right, guys, take it away. The Toy Maker, B, the Daleks, or C, the Cybermen?
Now, this is just from the new specials, and I'll say it, the Toy Maker.
Toy Maker? She's absolutely right. There it is, the Toy Maker. Abby, you guys are smashing this. All right, Terrell, we have one for you, another piece of music. Okay. You're going to tell us which villain is associated with this song. Take it away, guys. What do you think? Is it the Weeping Angels, the Master, or the Zygons?
That would have to be the Master from last year.
You're saying the Master?
Yep.
He's absolutely right. Here he is, the Master, everyone. Wow. Look at that. Well, you guys clearly are both super fans. So I believe, if I've done this right, the final scores will be Abby got 3, you got 3, which means it is actually a draw. Give them both a big round of applause. Both clearly super fans. But hey, Terrell, don't you go anywhere because you're hanging around to show us how to make one of these, your very own reversible, cuddly Meep. It's all very exciting and I want to keep this for myself. So don't go anywhere. In the meantime, let's have a look at part 2 of Verity's incredible adventure through time and space where her dreams came true. Have a look. And now for the moment Verity has been waiting for.
Only the crew and cast of Doctor Who can visit the new TARDIS. But as Verity is our competition winner, she's been given exclusive access. It really is bigger on the inside.
Designer of the TARDIS, Phil, gives us the tour.
What do all these buttons do?
I don't want to touch anything in case we take off, Abby. What does this do?
Makes anything the Doctor wants.
Anything the Doctor wants?
Yeah, so far we've only made coffee with it.
Thank you very much.
What would you want?
Ice cream.
Ice cream. I like that.
See all these round doors in the walls? Where do you think they should go to?
I think that one right there should be a library. That one down there should be a cafe.
A cafe? Go on then.
You have to go down.
You
to
lead
get
the way
to
then.
One.
This prize-winning access means Verity has full run of the TARDIS.
She'll never catch me. Never. she's gonna get me. Okay. She found me.
We can't visit the TARDIS and not take her for a spin around the studios. And I know the perfect person to visit.
Abby.
The one in charge of the whole universe.
Set us up. Ready?
Go on.
Whoa. Whoa. Whoa, we're going.
Hold on tight, Verity. Abby, are you good?
We're rolling.
Oh, hang on, Abby.
Whoa.
I need you to hit that button right there. That one.
Hold on, guys. Get ready to land.
That's pretty good.
Let's see where we have landed.
I think we should knock before. Ready?
Come in. Hello. Hello, Verity.
Russell T. Davis was the competition head judge.
I'm very excited to meet you, Verity. Thank you for this. And well done. Congratulations.
What did you think of my design?
I loved it as soon as I saw it, actually, because it's so clever. It's like someone's taken your whole imagination, like you took every idea into your brain and you packed it into the shape of the TARDIS. And actually, that sums up Doctor Who for me. Are you proud of it?
Yes.
You should be.
So do you have any questions for Russell?
Do you have any spoilers to share?
I would be locked in a cupboard if I gave away a single spoiler. I'd love to, Verity.
Who is your favourite Doctor?
I can't answer that because I might bump into one of the other doctors tomorrow. When I was your age, I loved Tom Baker. But now I have to professionally say all doctors are equal.
If you could use the TARDIS, where would you go?
Oh, I think I'd go 1,000 years into the future. I'd love to see where we are.
Where would you go, Verity?
Well, at first I wanted to go forwards and go to all of my birthdays and steal all of my presents.
Oh.
No, that is a good idea.
But then I thought on my other birthdays I wouldn't get any presents because a younger me would come and steal them.
Yeah.
That's very true.
How does the Doctor know where and when he is without looking outside the TARDIS?
You know, I can step out the door and I know I'm in Cardiff and I know whether it's sunny or whether it's raining. And even without looking at my watch, I kind of know what time of day it is, you know? So the Doctor's like that, but on a huge scale. Sniffs the air and he thinks, oh, I'm probably on this planet at this time. That's a great question. No one's ever asked me that before.
What's your favourite monster?
I have a real love of the Daleks. I grew up loving them. I will always love them.
How do you come up with the ideas for the monsters?
It's kind of like the other way around. I've got my job and I do this job because I keep thinking of monsters. So the ideas come first, in a way, and I just happen to find a job that fit them. And I think you're the same. I think you're full of art. You're full of ideas, Verity. I think you could do the same thing. Congratulations on winning the contest.
Thank you.
Thank you. Absolutely love it. Brilliant.
I want to say thank you so much for your time, and also thank you so much for being involved in the judging process. So, Verity, if you could give this to Russell.
No way.
And this badge is to celebrate the 60 years of Doctor Who. Oh,
look at that. Absolutely beautiful. Thank you so much. Doctor Who's been on Crew Peter ever since I was your age, and I think the two programmes go together beautifully, and it's an honour to be part of this. Thank you.
Thank you to you.
Verity, what a day. Have you had fun?
This has been the best day ever.
Oh, yeah!
Thank you so much, Doctor Who and Blue Peter.
Well, I've got to tell you, Abby, honestly, one of the best experiences of my entire life. I loved it so much. But now it's time to see how you guys have been earning your badges in this week's
Big Badge Wall!
Look at it, Abby. It's lovely.
It is absolutely magnificent. So let's see how many we can shout out before we hear this noise.
Good.
Good theme song. Okay, let's go!
Let's take it away, right? You go, Abby.
First up, we've got Harkarit, age 10, is on this amazing Dalek drawing, shouting 60, 60, 60 to celebrate 60 years of Doctor Who!
I'm loving it. Have a look. This is Stanley, who's 10 years old, photographed outside the TARDIS, channeling his inner Doctor Who. I think we might have a future Doctor here. Loving your work, Stanley. Badge on the way.
He really looks at the part. Next up, we've got Erin, age 12, to celebrate 60 years anniversary, set in a drawing of David Tennant and a TARDIS, and even the Blue Peter ship. Pretty cool.
I'm absolutely loving that work. Hey, Archie sent in this lovely picture covering his own book that he wrote and then sold to raise money for charity. He managed to raise £53. Badge on the way to you. Super inspirational work.
Never fail to amaze me on this badge wall. Well, Leo, age 9, has done this amazing drawing of a Dalek and includes an acrostic poem for Doctor Who. And it features the Weeping Angels, my favourite monster.
Well, the Weeping Angels are my favourite monster as well. We are out of time. Oh, it always goes so fast, the big badge wall. Well, thank you to everyone who sent in your amazing post for this wall. It looks absolutely awesome. And here's the thing. If you haven't got yourself a badge, what are you waiting for? You want to get one, get yourself onto the Blue Peter website where you can find all the details. There's even more Doctor Who goodies on there as well for you, including our very own Build Your Own Sonic Screwdriver game. You've got to give it a go. It's so much fun. And speaking of Doctor Who, you know what? I think Abby has something up her sleeve for us. She's going to show you how to make your very own reversible cuddly meep. Abby, what have you got for us?
I really do have it here, but here it is, your very own meep. Meep, meep.
Meep, meep.
And that is very cool. And also, Tyrell is here with me as well to help me out. And if you don't know about the meep, it is actually a new creature in the new specials that have just come out. But, Tyrell, I think that you have a little bit more experience talking about it. Can you tell me a bit about the meep?
Yeah, so the meep actually goes way back to like the 1980s comic books. It's a little creature that's from an adorable little planet, but secretly is actually really evil and wants to take over the world. So the Doctor has to stop it before it does.
Yeah, well, ours is friendly right now, but it actually turns fierce too. I'm loving the fact it's got so much history in it as well. Now, if you want to make one for yourself, then all of the information that you need is on the screen right now. But for even more of the details, head to the Blue Peter website with all of the instructions. And the main thing is, it's just some fluffy socks that we're remaking.
Love it.
It's pretty awesome. So we're going to start out with these fluffy socks right here. We're going to lay them out. And what you want to do is you want to cut them just below the ankle. So if you could chop them right there.
Just below the ankle?
Yes. Okay. And I've got a little trick. So to make it very even, because we want both sides of the meat to be the same size, is if you pop this one on top of the second sock and then cut along that line.
I can do.
Thank you very much. There we go.
There we are.
And then turn one of those socks inside out.
Okay.
Just like so. And line up those two seams that you have just cut.
All right there.
And then you're going to kind of sew it along here as well. But you need to leave a hole in there so that you can start stuffing it, because you can't have an empty meep. That would be ridiculous. So if you can stuff that for me there. Not too much, because we want to be able to fold it inside out.
Gotcha.
Now, tell me a little bit more about the meep in the show. How does it actually work?
Yeah, so the meep that we see in the show is actually an animatronic head that can, you know, blink and have little facial expressions. But there's a person inside crouched down and doing all of the movements. Yeah.
That is incredible. It's so technical. But you can actually see kind of like the different face shapes of it. And, you know, we do actually need, oh, there it, is going on there right now. Oh. That's very awesome, but, you know, it has two different faces for it as well. It's not going to be the same expression.
Yeah.
So we have just the thing for you to help you out with making the face. Thank you very much for stopping that there.
Of course.
We actually have a template on the Blue Peter website.
Oh, yeah.
And it includes the friendly eyes, it includes the fierce eyes. They can put on either side of you, and it also helps you out with the little ears as well, because it's such a good characteristic part. Now, I'll show you right here. We have our little kind of felt bits. You can use different fabrics though as well. So you can use the end bits of your socks that you've cut up, or different parts of it. So if you can put together a little eye for me with that glue right there, and we've got a little button for it as well. Very cute.
Love it.
I'm gonna pop that. And then, so you can use fabric glue, you can use glue, or you can sew it. So we've sewn it on our meat just to make it extra secure, which is very sweet.
Now,
what is your favorite monster? There's loads of monsters in Doctor Who over the 60 years.
Yes.
So it might be difficult to choose a favorite.
Oh, so my favorite has to be a creature called the Midnight Entity. Bit of an obscure one, but it's one that you can't see and actually takes over the minds of its victims and absorbs everything that it sees.
It's really interesting. It's the one that kind of like repeats everything that you say as well.
Yeah.
Really scary.
Really scary, yeah.
Okay, so I'm gonna pop this eye on right here. So I'm going to do it on my map here. So this is one that's been stuffed and can turn inside out.
Okay.
So I'm going to glue that here, and it looks great. So you have a lot more time at home. Just chill out with it. We have a very limited time with it. So there we go. So you can also make the ears as well. We have the little cutouts for it, but you can do it with a seam as well on the edge of the sock. So the ones that you've just cut up, and then you can just sew it along the side. You can use felt, but we wanted to make it a little bit stiffer so you have the really characteristic cute little ears with it. So it looks really good. The best thing about this meat toy as well is it can almost be like a little mood toy. You can tell people whether you are a bit sad or you're very happy.
Yeah.
It's very nice.
I love it.
Well, thank you so much, Terrell, for actually helping me this make. I'm loving it. Well, you have lots of time at home to do it, and make sure if you want to make it as well, go onto the Blue Peter website. Now, Joel, what are you thinking? Friendly or fierce?
Friendly or fierce, Abby? I can only think one thing, and that is the most incredibly cute thing I've ever seen in my entire life. My plan is to make like 100 of these things, gather them all around, cuddle up, it's gonna be beautiful. And hey, this entire thing has made me wanna go and watch more Doctor Who.
Definitely.
How about you, Abby?
There's a Christmas special that you can actually check out with it. And here is an action-packed sneak peek.
Ooh. Merry Christmas. I'm the Doctor.
Oh yeah?
Who are you?
Oh, I don't know about you, but I'm so, so excited to see that, Abby.
It's going to be absolutely incredible. I can't wait to see the action-packed 15th Doctor as well.
No, there's so much to look forward to. Well, hey, thank you so much, Terrell, for coming in. Thank you so much to the Phoenix boys. Big round of applause for these guys as well, because that was incredible work. And hey, in the meantime, you guys got to go watch more Blue Peter on the BBC iPlayer. Make sure you go do. And until then, we're going to see you next time. For now.
Yes.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Saturday mashup this weekend, Strictly's Nadia and Kai and the cast of The Famous Five, plus Bake Off winner Matty will be facing the filters, and we've got music from the lovely Tilly Lockie. Join us this morning from 9 on CBBC and iPlayer.
Brand new and exclusive to BBC iPlayer, it's Pokemon Horizons. Meet Liko and Roy, a dynamic duo joining forces.
That was an awesome combo!
To unveil new secrets.
Pokemon!
Across the world of Pokemon. But beware, the mysterious explorers are hot on their tail in search of Liko's magical pendant. Catch all the action now in this brand new series. Pokemon Horizons, exclusively available to watch on BBC iPlayer.
Christmas is here on the CBBC website, and do we have some presents for you? Head on over to Creative Lab for all your artistic needs. From Christmas memes to a festive Henry makeover. Flee the peelers on the streets of London in Dodger Dash, collecting coins and power-ups to unlock some festive outfits. Or get your snowballs ready, Cockers, and help hackers save the Christmas panto in Panto Panic. All this and more on the CBBC website.
Topical news on the Kids Zone on BBC Two. News Round.
Happy Saturday, everyone. It's me, The Graft, with your weekend bulletin live on BBC Two. Now, I've got some great stuff coming up over the next few minutes, including a pretty unusual nativity scene and Martin's top tips on how to make the best paper snowflake.